word. And that same call that Paul echoes in the book of Romans when he writes, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind so that you may discern the will of God. What is good and what is acceptable and what is perfect. Paul got it. And the call to conversion, that we hear in Peter's message and in this passage from Acts isn't about confessing how messed up we are and then moving on to whatever makes us feel good, moving on to the new religion type things. This call is for us to have a new mind, or transforming our minds so that we can see things in a totally new and totally different light. It's not changing our opinions. It's not about adopting a new theology or adopting a new ideology. It's not about moving to the left. It's not about moving to the right. This calls us, this call to conversion that comes in this passage has to do with having a new mind and a new mindset. It comes with transforming our minds out of the modes that are dictated to us by the world that we live in, and sometimes by our own ego. We become, as this transformation takes place, we become in the process something totally and completely new, almost as if we had been recreated. What did Jesus say to the rich young ruler? Ye must be born again, recreated. Are you connecting the dots between some of these things here? This is Paul's take on the subject. Hear him again. Listen to his words from 2 Corinthians. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. It's not about judgment. It's not about shame, shame, shame. It's about change. It's not about finger pointing or trying to get someone to accept my view of things. It's about inviting people around us to have a transformation that's so complete that they will feel as if they've been born from above, like John tells us. And I have to be, as I've studied this, I've got to be honest with you. This is scary to me. This is scary to me because I'm not sure I quite got a handle on born from above. But I do know that all of the scripture says we need to be made new. We need to repent in the sense that we need to change our mindset, our points of view, our biases, our prejudices. There's all sorts about us as humans that needs to change, and it needs to change not from the outside in, but from the inside out. Probably the best illustration that I was able to find about life transformation is this. We can look at a drunk stumbling down the street, and that can be a really good object lesson, and you know, we can see it here without any problems at all, until the drunk stands up and starts extolling the virtues of sobriety. There's a little bit of disconnect between that drunken person saying how wonderful sobriety is, or a boxer who stands up and talks about nonviolence. There's a disconnect. It doesn't work. Well, folks, a non-transformed Christian has a real problem inviting others to be Christ-like. if their lives don't show that change that Christ brought forth. Think about it. Think about it. Could Peter have issued his call so powerfully if his life had been unchanged? Think about Paul. Paul's the obvious one. Could Paul, after chasing the new church all over so that he could persecute and kill Christians, how could he have become the apostle that he was without the change that he underwent and the new mind that God gave to him? If we hope, if we have any hope of bringing others into the church and into the saving knowledge of Christ, then they have to be able to see our authentic faith journey. They have to see where the repentance was, where the conversion was, where the new mindset is, and it sounds simple, and it's true, but it's not easy. So I ask you this morning, can we step into this kind of repentance together? This move that I'm talking about toward transformation, this move toward change, can we hold hands and do this together? Can we have a vision of what our lives personally and as a body of Christ here on this corner would be like if we laid everything down? If we put aside our biases and our prejudices and our agendas, and if we allow Christ to work inside of us and change us, that's our challenge. It moves us very quickly beyond our drive to convince others, hey, we have the best religion. There's all sorts of books out there about that. And that doesn't change a whole lot. Where change comes is when we change and others see that change in us and want to be a part of what we have. So, how do we do this? Let me give you some suggestions. We pray together. Oh my. We pray together that we might step onto this path of repentance. And we step onto this path of change. And then we pray that the change in my life, the change in our lives, will be seen and in our transformation, in the new life that we experience, we become a catalyst for change in the world around us. Isn't that what Jesus called his disciples to be? Isn't that why Jesus was a radical beyond belief? Jesus turned the world upside down, and the world needed it. Today, folks, we are called to turn the world upside down. And the world needs it. Our prayer is that we can be agents for change in this world. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.